Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied the various properties like atomic radius, ionic radius as well as the ionization enthalpy. And now we are moving towards the next property known as electron gain enthalpy. So let us talk about that. So now we are talking about electron gain enthalpy. So let us understand that what is actually electron gain enthalpy. So it says that the enthalpy change accompanying the process in which one electron is added to a neutral gaseous atom to convert it into a gaseous negative ion. That kind of change that we observe is basically known as electron gain enthalpy. So that kind of energy change that we'll observe is known as electron gain enthalpy. So that is what I want to explain. For example, if we have an atom, a gaseous atom like X, suppose. If this is the gaseous atom that we have, and in this case, because it is neutral now, in this case, because it doesn't acquire any extra positive charge or neither an extra negative charge. So suppose if I have add an electron in this case. So if I have added an electron in this case, so what will happen is basically now this atom, which was basically neutral, it doesn't acquire any positive charge or negative charge, but because of electron has been added in this atom, so what will happen, this will convert into an ion or an atom which will acquire a negative charge. So therefore I could say it as it is now converted into an ion. But the change in enthalpy that I would observe, so the change in enthalpy because of the gain of electron is known as the electron gain enthalpy. So that is when denoted by delta H and with a subscript of EG, electron gain. And in this case, because what happens is usually electron gain enthalpy has a negative value, and this is why. Because what whenever it happens, when an electron is being added or when it has been when we are introducing an electron to an atom or to a negative species, so in that case basically energy is being released. So because the energy is being released from that particular system that we had a concern on that, so because the energy is being released, that's the reason the delta H EG is usually negative. And this kind of enthalpy change that we observe during the addition of an electron in a neutral gaseous atom is basically known as electron gain enthalpy. That is what you have understood. Very simple to understand. But let us talk about its trend also, and what does it, what are the other factors also that could affect the electron gain enthalpy. Let us talk about that. So before that, let us talk about the two trends that we know, that is in periodic table, that is in periods and in groups. So let us do that. So what happens when we observe the trend in periods? So the first thing that we have did already, that is we have did in screening effect also, that is the first thing that we could observe is the atomic number increases. So therefore the atomic number increases gradually. It increases gradually. So what happens the next is the electrons are being added in the same shell. So because of which the electrons on the outermost shell, they will go on increasing, and because of which the ultimate result would be the net nuclear charge of attraction that we have. In that case, it will go on increasing. So therefore the nuclear charge increases. So the nuclear charge increases. So what happens, because of the nuclear charge increases and and in that case, suppose if we have introduced an electron to an atom which is basically neutral gaseous atom. So in that case, because of the electron is being added, and moreover we could see that the nuclear charge is more in that case, that will lead to the more electron gain enthalpy. That means what I am trying to say, in that case the electron will be accepted with a loss of more energy. That means the delta H EG will be more negative. It will be more negative. That means the electron gain enthalpy will be more when we move across the period. So because of that reason, ultimately we could make a conclusion that the electron gain enthalpy increases across the period. Across the period, it goes on increasing. So these are the statements that we have made for electron gain enthalpy. The first thing that is, we obviously know that the atomic number increases, and because of which the atomic size go on decreasing because of the nuclear charge and the electrons that are added in the same outer motion. And nuclear charge increases, that leads to the atomic size that will go on decreasing. And moreover, what we could observe is, we could observe that because of this, nuclear charge will increase. And in that case, suppose if we have added an electron, so in that case, the electron will have more attraction towards the atom because the nuclear charge is more, and because of which basically the energy release will be more, and hence it would be more negative. That's the reason across the period when we move, the electron gain enthalpy will go on increasing. So now let us talk about what will happen in the group. So when we are talking about the group, basically the trending group, again a similar thing that we could observe is, we could easily observe that the atomic size increases, because we know the reason. We know the reason because the, as the atomic number increases, and the number, the atomic number increases very rapidly, and moreover the electrons that are being added, they will add on a new, because of which the number of shell will go on increasing, because the number of the atomic number goes on increasing, and because of which, if the number of shell will go on increasing, that will result in what? That will result in more shielding effect. So in this case, what we could observe is, because in group, in the group, what we observe is, we observe that the screening effect is more. So the screening effect is more, and because of which the nuclear charge decreases. So the third statement would be, easily, nuclear charge decreases. And that's the reason the atomic size goes on increasing. So now this plays a very vital role to understand that the nuclear charge, if it goes on decreasing, then it won't have that much of tendency to attract electron, that would attach to the atom so as to make a negative ion. So because the electrons that will attach to the atom will not produce maximum negative energy. Why? Because there is no nuclear charge. There is no effective nuclear charge compared to that when we observe in period. So because the nuclear charge is less, that's the reason the electron that will be added up in the atom will be the change in enthalpy that we will observe, it will be very much less. And that's the reason what we could make a statement as, it as that the delta HEG, that is the change in electron gain enthalpy that we observe, is less negative. Is less negative. And finally, we could say that ultimately the delta EG decreases down the group. It decreases down the group. So this is what we observe. So we'll make a quick review that what we have did and what are the trends that we have observed. That in periodic table we could see periods and trends. Periods and groups. So talking about the trend of that, so in periods what happens is, because of the atomic number goes on increasing gradually, and moreover the electrons are added up in the same main shell, because of which the nuclear charge increases and the atomic size goes on decreasing, and because of which what happens is the nuclear charge will be more, and that's the reason it will accept electron more easily, and because of which the change in enthalpy that we'll observe, it will be more negative. That's the reason we the electron gain enthalpy, when we move from left to right across the periodic table, it goes on increasing, means the negative value will go on increasing. And talking about in groups, what happens is, because the atomic number increases rapidly, and moreover we could see that the number of shell also increases, and because of the number of shell will go on increasing, and the rare electrons that are present, it will also increase, because of which they will increase the shielding effect, and increase in the shielding effect, which means decrease in the nuclear charge. And this decrease in the nuclear charge will make the electron gain enthalpy to be less negative. And that's the reason the electron gain enthalpy decreases down the group. So this is what we have observed, and we have made a comparison between the screening effect, nuclear charge and atomic size, because they both are related to each other, might be directly, might be inversely. So that is what we have did in this lecture. So this were the periodic trends just for electron gain enthalpy. I hope you have understood this video very clearly. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video, and you share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.